Tonight, candle of joy, Jesus' birth brought great joy to all who saw him.
I am reading from the book of Luke, chapter 2. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth, not clothes, and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
Let us pray. Prepare our hearts, O God, for the coming of Jesus Christ, your Son, by the memory of the world's great need of a Savior. Deepen our joy in making ready for the anniversary of his lowly birth at Bethlehem by true faith in him as the divine Redeemer. Strengthen our loyalty and our hope that his appearing in glory, we may welcome him as our risen Lord, our royal Master, the Savior of our souls. Amen.
Engineer Jose Rizalde Harder, our chairman of the Church Council, will share to you the warmth of the Church's welcome.
And we also greet you, Merry Christmas. This year we celebrate at the University Church its 104th year. And as the year closes in December, we celebrate this Christmas cantata. Tonight, therefore, I would like to welcome those who are here for the first time. Welcome, and may you be blessed with your presence here today. I'd like also to welcome visiting and returning Centralians who are here. Welcome to the university, as well as to our fellowship and celebration for this evening. I'd like also to welcome international students who are here and international guests who are with here tonight. Welcome. We welcome as well fellow Christians from various churches in the city and in the province, as well as auxiliary churches or outreach churches of the University Church who are here tonight. We welcome finally members of the University Church family, from our kids to the youth, to the adults, and to the most elderly among us. I welcome you all in behalf of the University Church Council, our pastoral staff, auxiliary organizations. Welcome for tonight's cantata presentation. Tonight's cantata, entitled The Heart of Christmas, was specially prepared and presented by the University Church Choir, the Bahandit Church Choir, the Jubilant Choir, the UC Praise and Worship Team, even our UC Children's Choir, and I think the UC Tambourine team. These musical pieces did not just come out from a single musical piece, but it was decided to be now a collection of special musical pieces through the years that has been sung here at the University Church. Tonight's musical cantata, therefore, is exceptionally special, and we thank the Lord for this privilege that this can be shared to one and all tonight. Tonight's musical is not a presentation, but it is a celebration of what this season meant and bring to all of us. Our church members or choir members are not here to deliver a repertoire of musical pieces, but to bring to you a message that is capable to bring spiritual transformation in each of our lives, not just here, but is able to impact here in our lives in eternity. And now, to set our mood and focus on the message of tonight's cantata, let me just invite you to reflect on these few things. The Heart of Christmas, which is also the title of our musical cantata tonight, is not about the glitter, but more importantly about the grace of God that He fulfilled, that through His grace we will know Him, that He will dwell among us, and that we can have fellowship with Him. The Heart of Christmas is also not about the present, which we oftentimes expect to receive and to give. The Heart of Christmas is about the presence of one who is God's gift to us, one of whose gift, if you have not received, your life will be empty and your Christmas will be meaningless. Tonight's cantata, or the Heart of Christmas, finally, is not about the fun and the fellowship that we have at this season, but it is about the message of forgiveness, which is at the heart of Christmas. I remember one of our instructors before in religion, Pastor Acosta Hoppen, said, "If our greatest need is entertainment, God would have sent us Michael Jackson. If our greatest need had been technology, God would have sent us Bill Gates, and his innovation would have been enough. If our greatest need had been wealth, then Warren Buffet and his company would be sufficient, but it's not. Our greatest need is forgiveness. That is why God sent us His Son, Jesus Christ, to restore unto us before God and to give us forgiveness. This is the message of Christmas. This is the heart of what Christmas is all about. Reconciliation of one who sinned to the one who cannot sin. Therefore, let us prepare our spirits in our hearts, for tonight we will discover, we will recover, and we will uncover the best of what Christ has done for us this season. It is Him whom the Bible declares as a wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Welcome, and may God bless each one today present as we witness this special cantata. Good evening.
With open hearts and minds, let us pray together with Reverend Samuel Escobin.
We sing because the child is born. We sing because the Son is given. Oh God, You are home. From heaven You came down and dwelt among us. Grant that our celebration be an occasion to honor the King of Kings, to praise the Lord of Lords, and to magnify Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
We bring and present our white gifts. If you have brought any gift that you'd like to present as your white gift offering, Please bring them to the altar now. Have you ever thought that Christmas began on that silent night of Bethlehem? Well, Christmas actually began before that, in the mind of God, when He first gazed into emptiness of the infinite and imagined the amazing world. And then He spoke. That was the beginning. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the world, and the world was made through Him, but the world did not know Him. He came to those who were His own, but His own did not recognize Him nor receive Him. But to all those who did receive Him and believed in His name, He gave them the right to be children of God. The Word became flesh and made His home among us. We have seen His glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Then the Lord created a man He named Adam, and gave him a woman to love, and called her Eve. He placed them in a beautiful garden, where the fruit of only one tree was forbidden. But they ate that fruit, and that first sin separated the people from their loving Creator. It was then that God knew He must send a Savior. The Savior came to a world that did not know Him, even if the words of many prophets had foretold His coming. One prophet said, "A star shall come forth from Jacob, and a scepter shall rise from Israel." Another said, "As for you, Bethlehem, from you one will go forth to be ruler of Israel." Still another said, "A virgin will be with child and bear a son and call his name Emmanuel."
Thank you. been cursed and tagged, now you're stuck in, so I just can't wait.
To do this again?
What do you mean, son? We celebrate Christmas every year.
I know, Dad, but why do we need to decorate?
To make the place festive. To make it look joyful and happy. It's Christmas season. People should be looking forward to it with joy and anticipation. Son, what's Christmas about?
It's about decorations, it's about food, and Christmas sale.
Christmas sale?
Yeah, Mom keeps on talking about that. And it says so here, in this tablet.
Let me see. Oh no, Damien, it means more than that. Try again, what's Christmas about?
It's about baby Jesus born on Christmas Eve. I remember that from my Sunday school.
Exactly.
Dad, still don't get it. Why do we need to decorate?
Do you remember who Jesus is?
He is the Son of God.
He is also the Messiah, the promised Savior. 2,000 years ago, the people of Israel weren't happy.
But wasn't Israel the chosen people of God?
They are, son. And because they were God's chosen people, other nations would always try to conquer them. Sometimes God would let them be conquered by other nations to teach them a lesson. Other times, it was the other nations who wanted to take over Jerusalem. But even though they were surrounded by enemies, God would remind them that He was there for them. It was when they remembered God's promise from the prophets that He will raise up among them someone greater than Moses and all the other prophets they have had. And like Moses, He will lead them to freedom. When the people of Israel remember that, you can only imagine how happy they were.
You will send the trust for you.
the glory of the Lord is soon to be revealed. His splendor on display and evermore concealed. His love will be our portion, His mighty power our shield.
And so the people waited and waited and waited. It had been already centuries when the prophecy was presented to them. Where was the Savior that the prophets foretold? Where was the Messiah? The hope they felt when they remembered the prophecies already began to fade.
Thank you. story, and he chose to be one of us. From a throne to a stable, from a crown to a cradle, and he chose to be one of us.
You see, son, during those days, people became so obsessed with self-importance and possessions that they were blind to God's simple but powerful love. They thought that the promised Savior would come with fanfare and would only save the prominent people. But God wanted to show His love to everyone, not just to the kings, princes, or nobles of the nation, but to the common people as well.
As a man made of dust, this is a miracle, this is a mystery, that he chose to be, he chose to be, he chose to be.
Almighty God, who created the planets, the stars, and the galaxies, came down to one small world, our world, and called it home. He who had thrown lightning bolts against the skies and carved out rugged mountain ranges with his fingers, slipped silently into the small, smooth body of a baby. He came to us as one of us, and we call this name Jesus.
Jesus, born to set thy people.
You know the story already, son, don't you?
Yes, Dad.
About the birth of Jesus?
Yes, Dad. Joseph and Mary went to Bethlehem, but because there was no room in the inn, they had to stay in the... I got it! They had to stay in the garage!
Garage?
Yeah, it's where they parked their donkeys and horses, right?
I think you mean stable, son. They didn't have garages back then. But you were right. There was no room for them in the inn. And they have to make a decision. They had little choice because Mary was already about to give birth to Jesus.
Dad, what would it have been like back then?
I don't know, son. But I can still remember the first time I held you when you were a baby. I couldn't describe the feeling, like I was feeling two things at once, like I was happy and in awe at the same time.
Awe?
Like I couldn't believe what was happening.
Maybe that's what Joseph and Mary felt when they were holding Jesus.
I can only imagine, son. Do you remember the verse in John 3:16?
For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Yes, you see, son, what Joseph and Mary held there that night wasn't just a baby boy. They were holding something more awesome, something more spectacular. They were holding the symbol of God's love, his only son.
Even though God made his son's birth so simple, he had visitors who witnessed his coming to earth that time. Do you remember who the visitors were?
The shepherds.
Okay. And who else?
The magicians.
Magicians? I think you mean magi.
Yeah, them. My Sunday school teacher said magicians were wise men during the time.
Well, they weren't like the magicians you have today. But yes, Joseph and Mary and baby Jesus had visitors who came to witness the prophecy coming true. The Magi had come from faraway nations, looking for the promised Savior, the promised King. They came with gifts. Do you remember what they were?
Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. My Sunday school teacher said, gifts fit for a king.
And your teacher was right. They were gifts fit for a king. And the Magi didn't just come to give the gifts. They knew the importance of the baby of this event. They came to worship this king. Shepherds do?
They watch and care flocks of sheep.
Okay, And what?
And they smell bad. At least that's what my Sunday school teacher said.
Well, maybe they smelled bad, but the shepherds had a hard life and were very unpopular among the people, especially the priests and the officials. They were the first to know the birth of Jesus. Why?
Because God loved them.
Yes, you're right. God loved them. He didn't care if they were unpopular or not. God still loved them. God was trying to tell the people of Israel, the world, of the extent of his love to us all by inviting the unpopular shepherds first to his son's birth. We don't need to be kings, presidents, or prime ministers. When Jesus came, he was for everyone, no exemptions.
Thousand years ago, our heavenly King did what no king should have done. He humbled his mighty, omnipotent self to form a simple baby. The Son of God gave up his throne in heaven so that he could come down to be with us, to be one amongst us. What greeted him here was barn, a stable, animals, smelly, unwashed shepherds were the first to kneel and worship him. Jesus already knew what would greet him here, the hardship of human life, the death of a loved one, the rejection, the betrayal, the hurts, and the pain. And yet, he still came because he wanted to be with us. He came because he loved us. Tonight, God is still reaching out to us. He is still reaching out to you. Jesus wants to be with you by coming down to earth, by spending time with the unwanted, and by healing the sick. Jesus showed to you that he is approachable. By taking the sins of the world, he showed the extent of his love for you. And through his resurrection, he is showing to you that in all his glory and majesty, the Savior of the world, the King of kings, and the Lord of lords is your friend. Tonight, he is here, waiting for you to take his hand, his invitation to be with him. Tonight, I ask you that you open your hearts to him. Just open your heart and let the Holy Spirit fill you. And let's worship the Lord.
Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the rush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place.
Let's claim it.
Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the rush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Of the Lord is in this place.
Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place.
Yes, the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ is in this sanctuary right now. The loving God who came as a baby, innocently, cruelly put on a cross to pay for the penalty of our sins. Tonight He's asking, would you like to surrender your life to Him? Make Him your Savior and Lord, that you can bow in worship before Him, His child.
We fall down, we lay our crowns at your feet, Lord Jesus. The greatness of your mercy and love at your feet, Lord Jesus. We cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lamb.
With thousands of angels,
we fall down, we lay our crowns at the feet of Jesus. The greatness of your mercy and love at the feet of Jesus. We cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lamb.
We cry, holy, holy, holy.
Shall we all stand, please?
We cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, Lord Jesus. Lord, let there be those among us who will make you be born in their hearts tonight, who will receive you as Savior and Lord, and truly worship you as God Almighty. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.
Heavenly Father, we love your precious name. Stands to reason that a name is just a word. It can be easily forgotten as soon as it is heard. But one name was spoken before the world's first day, and it will be here when everything that is has passed away. Delivered from the lips of God to Mary's ears and angel sings, Jesus, Jesus. The word that came to life for us, the song that all creation sings, Jesus, Jesus. The proudest nations of the earth have come and gone, but Jesus, the name lives on. When I'm awakened by a terrifying dream, and desperation reaches out and clutches me. When I'm so afraid that I don't even know how to pray, I simply speak it and I feel it, and it chases fear away. Delivered from the lips of God to Mary's ears and angel's wings, Jesus, oh Jesus. The word that came to life for us, the song that all creation sings, Jesus, sweet Jesus. The proudest nations of the earth have come and gone, but Jesus, the name lives on. Eternal hope and promise, the ever-great
gained a kingdom for the life that you've lost. You lived among us, our Savior and friend, and we praise you, Lord Jesus, again and again. Lord of all mercy, Lord of all joy, you claim the victory death can never destroy. You gave us new life that never will end. Oh, when we praise you, Lord Jesus, again and again.
Son, how does it look?
Looks great, Dad.
Now, do you know why we celebrate Christmas with decorations?
Because to make the place feel festive and joyful.
And why do we make the place festive and joyful?
Because through the birth of Jesus, we are given hope from sin. That's why we need to be happy, because we're given hope.
That's great, son. I'm glad you understood.
Oh, man! Christmas event is over. But it's okay. I have more fun decorating for Christmas today.
I'm happy to hear that, son. I enjoyed our time decorating as well. The joy of Christmas is saying yes to Jesus, the one who came to be one of us, the one who was born as a child, who lived as a man, who died as a savior,
and was raised to life as our eternal King. As we celebrate Christmas this season, let's become His ambassadors. Each one of us, let's live tonight carrying the wonder, the power, and the indwelling light of His amazing love into this world that He came to save.
Characters: Father, Son, Narrator, Mary, Joseph. University Church Children's Choir. Halal in Motion. University Church Cantata Choir 2017. Let's give them a big hand. The Jubilant Choir. The Bahandi Choir. University Church Cantata Choir. Let's call on the production crew. Thank you. our stage managers and the assistants. Let's give them a big hand. Lyrics, Patrick Vidag, the light control, Miss Michelle Sampani, and the music, Irene Joy. And let's give a big hand to our director, musical director, Joshua Jonathan Kimpo. Let's, once again, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big hand to our University Church Choir. Bahandi Choir, the Jubilant Choir, and most of all, let's give a big hand and our praises to the Lord Jesus Christ. Everybody, our praise and thanks to the Lord Jesus.
May I request everybody to please stand for the benediction. May the joy of Christmas linger in our hearts all year round, even as we bring the light of Christ to others, even as we share the gospel to people around us, to our families, to people in our workplace, even to our classmates. May the light of Christ continue to shine and bring about hope and release, bring about freedom to all the people that we met. I pray that the message of this Christmas will continue to linger in our hearts. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift His countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.